But George was gonna play his violin, but well, George wanted to put his name on his violin, and the violin got rather badly damaged in the typewriter.
I hope not.
Remember, if you want a tape of this, send $29.95 plus $4.50 for shipping and handling.
The scary part, Don, is that you knew the words.
And this will keep us on the air.
Actually, I missed a couple of words in there, but I was a little uptight here.
That dance thing that threw you off. You wouldn't concentrate so much on the dance you'd had at me.
Yeah, cut the choreography next time.
It's radio. We don't need to see the dance again, okay?
That's right. And now some card tricks here. Pick a card. No.
Hey, Greg, I want to talk to you a second.
What's that?
I want to talk to you here a second.
Where you want to talk to me at?
Right here.
Okay.
Where we are. You know, a long time ago when I started here, which was 10 years ago,
mm-hmm.
they used to keep the logs out here in the kitchen cupboard, in the lower kitchen cupboard.
Yeah.
And on those Saturday nights when we played those tapes from 6 to 9,
yeah.
I wouldn't have anything to do.
Yeah.
So I'd go through those logs, and I'd be like, Gregory C. Hoover, cool.
It's actually C. Gregory, but don't tell anybody.
Yeah, right. Right. That was pretty neat. And
we had to do something with those kitchen cupboards, you know? You just can't let them sit there empty and everything. But
yeah,
that long ago.
Yes, and they were dusty and everything. I mean, they were really old.
No, what are you implying? What's the implication here, Sandy? I want to know. Is this because I started here... And I always say this is my, it'll be 1970, what, how many is it, 27 years, and I was 3 when I started, so it works out pretty good. You figure it out.
When did you start here? The year I was born?
Well, that hurt. That's good.
I'm
the
sorry.
Year she was born.
Hey, you're a good guy.
All that Grecian formula.
That's right. That's right. Still somewhat dark hair there, and still have hair. Hey. All right. It's radio, no one knows, okay?
So
now, 19. Thank you, Dick. Thank you, Dick. Dick's only been on the radio, 133 years? And he's saying, I'm old man. Oh, I tell you.
I said you look good.
Well, that's right. You did. That's true. But
Dick went to high school with Marconi, I think.
He's a great guy.
Yeah.
If it hadn't been for him, we wouldn't be here.
That's right.
That's right. It's a good point. But. Well, is this organized or what?
It's a little bit chaotic at this point, but it usually is behind the scenes.
What?
Well, usually when you guys are together, you don't hear any music anyway.
Well, that's true.
So,
what are you guys doing over there?
You would not believe what this individual said to me.
What individual?
We're having Linda. I can say that now.
Yeah.
Linda, she made a comment. She's having a rough time with it.
Yeah.
We all are, but we're, you know, keeping a stiff upper lip. But she said we could all go off the air with a mass suicide. Or Mike said that.
And you're taking credit for that, Mike. That's really smart.
I said that.
Mike's like, I'm really proud of that.
But Linda.
You're real proud to say that I said that.
Well, we'll all be on the roofs with assault rifles.
Linda said, here's your little cup.
Jim Jones lives.
Here's your little red cup.
Jim Jones lives. I'm not eating the pizza now. I don't know what you guys did to it. Staying away from that. Oh, okay, then it's safe.
There is one. There's one individual I would like to get on the radio.
Who's that?
Oh. That would be Aaron Thomas.
Aaron
I don't
Thomas.
Have to lower the mic for
Hi,
you.
Guys.
Hi, how
I
are
love
you?
You?
I love you too. Come on up here. Your dad has been after me for years upon years. Teach
I've
this girl.
You too.
I know.
Got
to get
out
your,
of it.
And now this day you get her on the radio.
And teach this girl the radio, and then he would leave her with me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'd say, come on, and she said, no, I'm not going to do it. I don't want to do it. But now she's up here.
She has some of that Thomas blood in her, right? You know, made up her own mind.
Yeah, but she doesn't holler at me though.
Oh, okay.
Like
some of the other ones do.
Like the other Thomas blood did.
That's quite all right. But now you're on the radio.
Now you're on the radio. What?
Oh, no.
So come on up here. Tell us a few things. How old were you when you started coming in here more with your dad?
Well, the day I was born. Well, probably the day after that.
Yes.
But, I'm 21, and I've been hanging out here for almost 22 years now. And, you know, you kind of grow up here. It's a part of life. I've known Bev since I was, what, 5 or 6? I don't know.
I watched her grow up.
Yeah, you did.
I can't see too well. I see as a dot from all the cameras.
The flashes.
Oh, my.
Cousin Harry, I remember he used to play Daddy's Girl for me every morning before I went to school.
Mm-hmm.
That was my song. And then you carried on the tradition.
But you know what I remember you doing? And this is going to really embarrass her, but hey, this is it, you know?
Uh-huh.
Do you remember the song Nobody from Sylvia?
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
remember
that?
The teeny boppers loved it. She would come out here. She'd come out here with this microphone.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to sing Nobody.
And Aaron will do that routine. Don? She's going to do it.
If Aaron doesn't, Don will. It's
That's right. Thanks, Aaron, for coming to the microphone. She's a sweetie.
Yes, it is. That's right.
That's right. So, well, it's fun. It's still happening.
It is still happening. Mm-hmm. I turned on the radio when I got in the car. I was doing a basketball game, and I could tell there was a party going on. And I thought, well, wait a minute, they're having a party without me.
had to crash it, right?
Yeah. So I thought, they didn't invite me. Maybe there's a reason for that. But I'm going down anyway. They can't stop me. I still have a key to this place. Until what? Tomorrow? Then it doesn't work. But right now. Right now, the key works well in the front door.
Yeah,
so.
I think things are going to lock up and change.
Yeah, I think.
Just a bit.
Well, they want to keep us out of here. Those guys keep coming
around.
You mean
to tell me I can't sneak in here and grab that piano, throw it over my shoulder, and skedaddle?
I want to watch that.
Bert's going to try to walk off with that one.
The security guards are coming in at midnight to check the record distribution here, too, you know. And I have the rap music. I already claimed it. I stole it from the foul. I'm sorry. That and the Led Zeppelin albums that Don had hiding in there somewhere.
I think it's news time.
It's news time.
Wow, it is. It's 5 to 11. It's news time.
Dun, 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 dun.
It's news time. We're standing. There she
is. Can you read like the horoscopes?
I'll get around to them.
Okay.
And at 5 minutes of 11 o'clock, it's time for the World Weekly News Report, Dateline Los Angeles. The L.A. school system is planning to teach 1960s hippie talk in public high schools.
Far out, that, dude.
Yes, groovy. That's the word from James Drofeld, an independent consultant for the L.A. County School Board, who says the new policy could go into effect in September at the start of the 1997-1998 school year.
One of those years, doesn't
matter. Already back, I'm flashing back as I'm standing here.
Brings back some memories for you, doesn't it?
Yes, the decision. The decision follows closely on the heels of the Ebonics controversy, in which Oakland school officials announced that they would be training teachers to speak and understand the slang spoken by Afro-Americans in the ghetto. That's 60s talk there.
That's true.
It's African-American now.
That's
remember, says sociologist Dr. Alice LeMays.
I don't think she's really a doctor.
But she plays one in the World Weekly News. Remember, many of these students are the offspring of flower children who were teens themselves during the late 60s. The students have heard nothing but hippie talk in the home and have difficulty adapting the normal English. Here's a typical conversation. I was grooving at my pad in the wee small hours when I got the munchies, scarfed, and crashed. Translation, I was enjoying myself at home very late at night when I got hungry, ate, and went to bed. Some further words that will be coming back into circulation in the L.A. school district. Chick, that's a female. Groovy, good, positive. Example, Jane Fonda is still a groovy-looking chick.
Wait, hold it. I debate that fact, but...
Yeah. Now, don't debate it with her husband. Ted Turner, yes. Trip out.
Yeah, you could do that.
Trip out. Here's one I don't remember. Take a mind-altering drug or simply set one's mind into a free imaginative state.
I like to ask Don why you don't remember that.
He's too young.
And far out. As in interesting or unusual, Jimi Hendrix was far out. Fuzz, that's a derogatory term for the police.
Well, we used to say farm out down here during the farm hour.
That's
okay.
Now, let's see. Where is the horoscope here? Supercomputer forecast. A little leader.
The radio station you're currently working at.
Yes. And now it's time for the giant horoscope.
Not to be confused with the small one.
Yes, or the medium or the economy size. The horoscope by Serena Sabak, psychic astrologer to the rich and famous. If you're an Aries, get ready to take advantage of an unusual opportunity that may be coming your way in the week ahead.
Like what?
Ask for expert advice if you must, but don't waste my time. There was one in here about
be something in there good.
Doctors, something about dog astrologers.
It's come to this, Don, hasn't it?
Yes, it has.
It really has.
Boy, you know, I picked
your
the World Weekly.
Your life has really taken a downward spiral, I hate to tell you.
Right. Have you
From
checked
once
your
news person to reader of the rags.
This would be a step up in many ways. I bet what a job it would be to write stories like, have you checked your pet's horoscope today? Dateline Los Angeles. The latest wacky fad among Hollywood celebrities is a real howler. Horoscopes for pets. The rich and famous shell out up to $3,500 for astrological charts laying out what's in store for Rover or Princess. A typical daily horoscope for a pet reads, today is a good day to kick back, relax, and smell the flowers. Yeah. That's the horoscope every day for my dogs.
Well, Don, by the way, Dionne Warwick did call, and you do have a job.
Did she leave that 800 number? Yeah, that first call is free.
Yes, you'll be doing the psychic reading soon.
They have the LaToya Jackson psychic hotline advertised in here. Right from the courthouse,
right from down. Here's the
when it's open.
Yeah. Oh. So, actually, are you going to the news at 11 o'clock?
Okay. Nah, we're
There's
good.
There's no obligation.
Nah. Why bother?
Why bother? You know, I have to feel a little bad about this because they were playing some music before I walked
in.
Yeah,
then we get here, and you get here, and sure, that's the end of the music again.
No music again.
Well, milk it, boys.
We got a whole nother hour not to play music, so.
I hate
hey,
to
Bert.
Oh, bye, Bert.
Farewell, Bert.
So long, Bert.
Bert's leaving. It's a Bert alert.
As Jimmy Durante used to say, good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.
Good night, Bert.
Good night,
Bert. Say good night to Mrs. Calabash,
yeah,
too.
Right, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bert has left the building. Or is on his way out.
Wait till I go out to cheer.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Dead air.
Should I play some music?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I haven't gone to the pizza bar yet here, so I want to see what it's like. So.
Okay. It's 11 o'clock at WKSL, your good companion.
Well, I had 2 weeks vacation coming, so I thought I'd drive down to Florida, spend some time with an old friend, date a few girls, make a few parties, and just kind of live it up again. So I packed up my car, and then I called my mom in Tennessee and told her what I planned to do. She said, son, are you coming by? And I said, Mom, I'm really pushed for time, but I'll see you in a week or two. And I was driving through this little town in Georgia when I remembered, today's Mama's birthday. Well, I thought I'll just stop and wire some flowers. Shouldn't take too long, then I'll be on my way. So I walked in a flower shop, and the first thing I saw was this little boy with his eyes full of tears. I said, what's wrong, son? He said, Mama loves roses, and today's her birthday. And I haven't seen her in almost a year.
Roses for Mama, today's her birthday. Roses for Mama, today's her birthday.
He said, I live with Grandma now, but I promised Mama some roses, cause I talk to her all the time. I wanted to give her 5, because that's how old I am. But the lady said I couldn't buy them with just a dime. Well, a little fella's story kind of touched my heart, so I told the lady to give him what he wanted and charge it to me. Then I told her I needed to wire a dozen roses to my mama up in Chapel Hill, Tennessee. I looked around and the little boy was gone. But all of a sudden the door flew open and he come running back in. He said, Mister, I forgot to thank you for the roses. He smiled and shook my hand and ran back out again. Well, I started on out of town, and I was feeling real proud of myself for thinking of my mama and really caring. when I looked out the window and I saw that same little boy kneeling by a grave in an old cemetery. I stopped my car and walked over to where the little boy was kneeling down. And he smiled up at me and said, "This is where my mama stays. She says she sure does thank you for these pretty roses." Well, that's when I had to walk away. And I drove straight back to that flower shop and I said, "Lady, have you sent those flowers to Tennessee?" She said, "No, not yet." I said, "Well, never mind. I'll just take them back with me."
Roses for Mama to face the birthday. Roses for Mama to face the birthday.
Now this is the real Adam side we all want to hear. It's 4 after 11 at WKSL.
From Adam's side, God formed his bride, beautiful as could be. And standing here beside you, I see he's done the same for me. I've waited such a long time, and I can't believe it's true. That by my side, God's placed a bride, beautiful as you. There were times when my impatient heart didn't want to wait for you. It just seemed like you would never come, and I didn't know what to do. I almost gave up waiting and started looking on my own. But then the Lord brought you to me, flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. From Adam's side, God formed his bride, beautiful as could be. And standing here beside you, I see he's done the same for me. I've waited such a long time, and I can't believe it's true. That by my side, God's placed a bride as beautiful as you. I promise that you will always be a treasure in my heart, to have and to hold so tenderly till death do we part. With this ring I pledge to you a never-ending love that will carry you through all we do till we reach our home above. From Adam's side, God formed his bride, beautiful as could be. And standing here beside you, I see he's done the same for me. I've waited such a long time, and I can't believe it's true. By my side, God's placed a bride as beautiful as you. I've waited such a long time, and I can't believe it's true. That by my side, God's placed a bride as beautiful.
All will be gladness when we shall join that happy band. No tears in heaven. no tear up there, no tear in heaven will be known.
Yeah, thank you for that horn tooting.
Glory, I'm waiting, waiting up yonder, where we shall spend an endless day. There with our Savior we'll be forever, where no more sorrow can dismay. No tear, no tear, no tear up there, sorrow and pain will all have flown. No tear, no tear, no tear up there, no tears in heaven will be known. Some morning yonder we'll cease to ponder for things this life has brought to view. All will be clearer, loved ones be dearer, in heaven where all will be made new. No tear, no tear, no tear up there, sorrow and pain will all have flown. No tear, no tear, no tear up there, no tears in heaven. No tears in heaven, no sorrows given, all will be glory in that land. There'll be no sadness, all will be gladness, when we shall join a happy band. No tears, no tears, no tears up there, sorrow and pain will all have flown. No tears, no tears, no tears up there, no tears in heaven will be known.
Your good companion, 94.3 WKSL, 10 minutes after 11. Thanks so much for listening. I sure am having a great time. I want to thank them so much for letting me sit in this chair one more time.
In the dawn of the midnight, have I not hid my face while the storm howls above me and there's no hiding place? Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry, keep me safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Yeah.
I can.
94.3 WKSL.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, by the way, a caller had called in. This is another one of Cousin Harry. The Pocono Mountains. Pinocchio.
Pinocchio Mountains.
I don't remember that.
Tell us about
but
it.
But I remember. Do you remember when Ronald Reagan had that begin tumor? You remember that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cousin
Harry.
Greg, please.
My uncle, your cousin.
Oh, no, we loved him. We loved him dearly.
On the way down, I kept hearing all these voices from the past, and I expected to hear his.
Oh.
But he's.
He's watching us from above with that bottle of Pepsi and that hoagie that he always had here each morning.
Rolling.
Well, the old clock on the wall says it's time to get on out of here, he would say. Yeah. He was fun.
That boy's coming up next.
Mm.
Never knew my name. He's my nephew, my uncle. That's being back there.
Is that better? What, am I doing? Oh, much. Knew how to do that?
No. That's secret stuff.
Well,
my sign language says you need to get a little closer to the mic.
Okay, I wasn't watching, you know, I had to translate for these guys.
That's right, you're doing the sign language there in the other room, and she came in here and immediately knew what you were trying to communicate to me, Sandy, and I'm standing here shrugging.
That woman's intuition thing, you know.
What? We have an estrogen bond.
Pardon me?
We're bonded by estrogen. All the women of the world.
That's right.
They just know what's going on.
Don't go there, Don. Stay away from me. Trust me on this.
Well, Don, you think it's going to be blowy out there tonight?
Oh, blowy, and if we get some snow, it'll be slippy in the morning, too.
Slippy.
The funny thing is... Slippy is like a word to a lot of people. Well, it's
it
not.
It is a word.
It's slippery. Don't you eat
Slippy pot pie?
Slippery.
Slippy beef pot pie.
Listen.
So what time?
That made me come in there and red up that room.
So what time do you think you'll crawl out of bed tomorrow, Don?
Oh, me?
Mm-hmm.
Well, gosh, let's see. I don't have to do anything. This is several hours past my usual bedtime. Probably get up about noon. That's right. I think I had 6 months to do nothing and get paid for it.
Money for nothing.
Okay, you want to we'll play some music and then come back a little later and talk with a little more sense, you think?
Oh, yeah, when we make some sense. I'm getting a little punchy here. I've been up a long, long time, Sandy.
Find some sense and then come back to me.
All right, I'll slap myself in the face a couple of times. Spin us a tune, baby.
Your hand, let's agree together that all of our enemies will crumble at our feet. For whatever we find on earth shall be found in heaven at the name of Jesus. Satan has to flee. 'Cause we've got the power in the name of Jesus. We've got the power in the name of the Lord. Though Satan rages, we cannot be defeated. 'Cause we've got the Satan's tried to stop us, but the Church of Jesus is still alive. like a mighty army. We keep marching onward, winning every battle with the Lord by our side. 'Cause we've got the power in the name of Jesus. We've got the power in the name of the Lord.
We've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
Though Satan rages.
Though Satan rages.
We cannot be defeated.
We cannot be defeated.
'Cause we've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
Now everybody sing it with us. Come on, we've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name.
Oh yes, we've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
Oh, though Satan rages.
Satan rages.
We cannot be defeated.
We cannot be defeated.
'Cause we've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
Yes, we've got the power.
We've got the power.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
Laverne Tripp and We've Got the Power, 94.3 WKSL. Good evening, I'm Matt Scott. It's 20 minutes after 11 o'clock here on your good companion, WKSL. I guess we've got, what, a good, 40 minutes left. And I just want to thank everyone for coming in this evening. Thanks to Sandy for going on the air. It's been great, and I'm sure we'll hear from you some more before the night's over. And just thank everybody for being here. It's been great. I was really concerned about this evening and how it was going to turn out, and I just thankful for everybody being here to support me. And I got a call from a friend of mine, Leroy Bunker, a few minutes ago. And he asked me to play him one last song, and wasn't sure what to play for him, but he's been a really great friend for years to me, and I want to I'm thankful to him and to Wanda, and just the time that they take and spend with me, and invite me out to do things, and that means a lot to me. And so we'll just play this for Leroy and Wanda this evening. Jeff and Sherry Easter and The Giver, 94.3 WKSL.
Once a babe was born in Bethlehem. what the Lord was giving to him, and starting all over to do it again, learning to live by giving all he could give.
Your good companion, 94.3 WKSL. Now we're going to take some time here and talk to Dick Bauer. Dick, how are you?
Am I on here?
You are on.
Okay, well, it's nice having you back here, Sandy. I missed you. But we're coming down to the end of the evening, and I did want to say that I've enjoyed being here at the radio station with these people, and I want Matt to know, too, I appreciate letting me on the air here at this time, along with you. And I've been running the Sunday evening program, Sounds of a Sunday Evening. And I always had a sign off there that I did want to tell the folks how much I enjoyed being with them on Sunday evening. And maybe someday we'll see you again on the radio. But I had a couple favorite quotes that I like to get over. And they are this, that remember, you're never fully dressed without a smile. And today is the tomorrow you're worried about yesterday. And happiness is like a butterfly. If you sit still long enough, it might alight on you. I just wanted to get those thoughts in tonight, Sandy. And it was so nice seeing you come back here. We've missed you. Because you and Bev, along with Don in the morning, were a scream. Three of the best in radio, as far as I'm concerned. Thank you for letting me say these words, and I know we're going to sign off here in maybe a half an hour, and it's been nice being with all of our wonderful listeners out there. I want to thank Mr. Thomas, Ben, for giving me the opportunity to continue in radio here, having been in it for so many years.
How many years, Dick?
Well, it's around